treat of a recital in July before we break for the summer. It's been an unusual year. But also, we welcome the fabulous pianist James Lisney, who's going to give us a programme of Schubert today, both neat and in transcriptions by Franz Liszt. He's going to talk to us more about it, but a very warm welcome, please, for James Lisney.
Thank you very much and good afternoon. And before I start, I would like to thank, on our behalf, Duncan Honeybourne, Francis Wilson, and the town chaplain, Neil Biles, for looking after us so well and making this event safe for us all in these times of difficulty for live concerts. If you really want to have a good sing-song, I suggest you go to a pub this evening and watch some football. But today, please, no cheering and no hugging of people outside your bubble. Just enjoy your piano recital. It's quite safe. Also, welcome to those who are watching online, which, of course, is now something after the pandemic I think a lot of us are going to hope to do a lot less of, but we've also now learned to become less frightened of the television screen now that it's watching us. I'm playing Schubert to you today, and three songs to finish, but before that, four impromptus. Schubert wrote eight impromptus, and he numbered the four that I'm going to play, 5, 6, 7, and 8. You may recognize the third of these pieces, as it was the introduction to talking about music, a favored program, a seminal program for me, given by Anthony Hopkins back in the 1960s and 1970s. You'll remember, it's a very genial piece, and the two pieces either side of that are also very genial dancing pieces, a waltz followed by this theme from Rosamunde, the ballet, and then a rich, wild Hungarian stomp to finish, and a plunge down the piano scale, which tells you when to clap. The first piece, though, it takes a little bit of description. It's always seems to be about to start, and then it's got this heart-stopping middle section where the treble and the bass talk to each other. It's been summed up by one analyst as not yet, followed by no longer. The no longer bit is the bit that really rips at the heartstrings, perhaps, where you hear a melody taken apart and becoming smaller and smaller as these two voices talk to each other. So these are the four impromptus written late in 1827 by Schubert.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
now we move to a combination of two of my favorite composers of the 19th century. Franz Schubert, of course, three love songs, but also Franz Liszt, one of the greatest musicians and perhaps not looked down upon so well in this country, even though he made a couple of visits to this country, and he may even have come to Weymouth. I'll have to ask Francis and Duncan about this. He did a West Coast tour, and I believe he came and played here. Whether he played this music, I do not know. This seems as though it may be a way of getting rid of a singer by writing a transcription for piano, a bit a true song without words. This is also a way for a composer and a pianist and a genius of Liszt's caliber to make a commentary about the music, what he feels about it. And he did actually give the three versions of interpretations, a sort of indication type of interpretation. One played again with full artistic fervor, and then the paraphrase and the transcription, which is another higher, perhaps, form of musical commentary on what we're doing, a higher form of interpretation. I'm afraid these days we look down upon these pieces, but they are marvelous, wonderful pieces, and rather more than bonbons. Three love songs, Liebesbotschaft to start, where the love's message is carried by a trickling brook, as it often is in Schubert. Then we go to the famous Ständchen, all this music written in Schubert's last year. Here the melody is transferred by the voice calling his love down to the grove, but also by the wind in the tops of the trees. And finally we come to a lovely little text by Seidel, not a great poet, but the one that Schubert chose for his final song. And it's for here, he uses a little friend to take his message. It's a little pigeon. So Taubenpost to finish. Liebesbotschaft, Ständchen, and then Die Taubenpost.
Thank you.
photo of you to show that there's a real audience. But I would have loved to have been able to recite some poetry at this point, because I thought it was particularly suitable for the life we've been living through these last months, but I'm not brave enough to do it. Beloved art, in how many a bleak hour when I am enmeshed in life's tumultuous round, have you kindled my heart to the warmth of love and borne me away to a better world? Often, a sigh escaping from your harp, a sweet celestial chord, has revealed to me a heaven of happier times. Beloved art, for this I thank you. So there's some music to go with these beautiful words, and it's really extraordinary music. It's very difficult music to sing, my singing friends tell me. And they told the pianist Gerald Moore, so he was very happy, as the world's most famous accompanist, certainly at that time, to transcribe this piece for two hands at the piano, and he used it as his final performance on the concert platform, but also quite regularly as the introduction music to Music Magazine on the BBC. So this is Andy Music by Schubert, transcribed by Gerald Moore.
A very touching end to a truly exquisite recital, and a very big thank you to James Lisney for coming and choosing such a beautiful programme and playing it so magically. I thoroughly enjoyed that, and I'm sure we all did. It makes a lovely end to what has been a rather short season, but I hope you have a good summer. Thank you for your support of the series, and I have some dates for your diaries. We resume our next season on Wednesday, the 15th of September. That will be a rather special concert. We'll welcome a pianist who grew up in Weymouth, Penelope Roskell. She hasn't played here for many years, and she'll be playing some Schubert as well, the last sonata, the sonata in B-flat. So that's a must for the diary, the 15th of September. Then on October the 27th, we'll be featuring the De Koenig Ensemble. They recently won the Chamber Music Prize at the Guildhall School of Music. That's a piano quartet, piano, violin, viola and cello. And we're going to be featuring the piano a lot next season as a solo instrument and also in chamber music. So that's an example of that on October the 27th. Then in November, on November the 17th, a violin and piano recital. So three dates for your diary: September the 15th, October the 27th, and November the 17th. But I know Francis will be in touch if you're on the mailing list, and if you're not, make sure you get yourselves on it very quickly. And we look forward to welcoming you in the new season. Have a good summer, stay well, and a huge thank you to James Lisney for a stupendous recital this afternoon. Thank you very much.